Hello, Cuticles! Welcome back to our channel. Once again, my name is Athon, and I am one of the admins of this channel. The other admin is Raul, who's right here, and he's the one filming this video right now. For today's video, I'm just gonna share some tips on how to communicate or show affections to your cat, to your pet cats. So, sa hindi pa nakakalam, me and Raul have 5 cats. I have 3 cats in my apartment. I have Gazini, I have Aki, and this one right here, Sky. And then Raul, he now has Orange. Orange is my original cat, and she's the mother of Aki, and Sky, and Lemon. So, ito si Lemon, oh.
Aww.
You don't know.
Hi, Lemon.
If you like videos about cats and want to see videos about how to take care of them, our lives with our pet cats, please subscribe so that you would see a lot of videos in the future. The very first thing that you have to remember in showing affections to your cat is hindi dapat sila pinipilit. So cats usually have their own terms. So if they want to show affections, just let them be. Sila yung dapat nauna. Hindi yung ikaw yung parang nagbe-beg ng affection nila, kasi hindi sila responsible when it comes to that. Dapat pag naglalambing sila, it's gonna be on their own terms. So this is Sky once again, and good thing that Sky is very responsive to petting. Pag pinipet mo siya, you would notice that pang pumipikit ng mata nila pag ano, pag hinihimas-himas yung ulo nila. That means they like what you're doing and they feel comfortable being with you. So hindi lahat ng cats ganito. Usually, most of the cats they just show affections by their own terms. Second, when you show affections or if you wanted to communicate with your cats, do not try to mimic their sound. Like, yung ginagawa ng iba na? Do not try to imitate the language, kasi they're pets, I mean, they're animals, so they have their own language. So if you wanted to convey a message to them, just talk to them. Yung usual na parang nakikipag-usap ka sa tao, kasi they would eventually understand you na yun yung language mo, and they would understand you na yun yung ibig mong sabihin. May mga words recognition eventually. Kaya yung mga pangalan nila, like kain na, come here, sit, ganun. Yun yung mga common words na madaling nakaka-capture ng mga pusa. And third, the most important thing is you should learn how to respond to their gestures. So let's say pag yung cats, or kahit sa alagang yung asa, if you have pet dogs, you should be responsive when they start to show their affections to you. You must pay attention to their gestures. If cats would lie down na naka-expose yung tummy nila, meaning they're comfortable being with you, they trust you, meaning hindi nila iniisip na threat ka para sa kanila. Pag nag-hiss yung cat, minsan may mga times na hindi natin maintindihan yung mga alagang pusa natin. Pag nag-hiss sila, just go ahead and let the cat alone. That means ayaw niyang magpa-istorbo. Ganun lang. So cats have their own terms. So instead na tayo yung amo nila, it's the other way around. So cats are usually our bosses. So yun. So I hope you guys like this video. Sana nakatulong ito somehow. If you have pet cats, I hope you like this video. Hit the subscribe button also so that again in the future you'd see videos like this. And magkita-kita tayo sa next na video. Once again, this is Ethel and thanks for watching the Cuticle channel. Bye-bye!